When you conduct the interview, the interviewer also must be aware what really affects the response. For us as a researcher, the response is very important. It should not get affected by external factors. So if we are careful enough to avoid those external factors, then whatever data you get is more valuable. So one must know how the response gets affected. There are three ways in which the response can get affected. One is predisposition of the respondent, other is predisposition of the interviewer, and the third is procedure which is used in conducting the study. Let us see each one of them separately. Predisposition of the respondent. If the respondent is hostile or suspicious about your research, then his or her responses will definitely get affected, because he or she has already selected a side, doesn't want to respond, but you are requesting, and that's why the responses are coming, so they may get affected. Sometimes it happens that the respondent is indifferent, not at all motivated to respond to your questions. You have selected, and that is why somehow they are now ready. So this disinterest or no motivation part on the respondent may affect your response, his response or her response, and naturally your data will get affected. Sometimes it happens that we think that this person may have this information, but interviewer may lack that information, and you are asking that information, that person doesn't know. If you come to know that this person doesn't know this information, you have to accept that selection of this respondent was wrong. But you cannot abruptly close that interview and go. You can close it properly and end that interview. But this may affect, because lack of information, lack of adequate information, lack of proper information, lack of accurate information may affect the response of the respondent. Sometimes it also might happen that the respondent wants to be in your good book, wants to please you, for whatever reasons. And that is why what happens then, they judge what is a favorable response, what you want, and they start giving you answers in that manner. This is not at all good for our data collection. If you sense this, then this has to be rectified, but this will get affected. Your data will get affected due to this kind of a response. Sometimes the respondent wants to do a favor to you by responding. So you can see the attitude changes, and this may affect the response. So as an interviewer or as a researcher, we must be careful about some of these things which affect the response of the respondent. Another way where your data gets affected through the responses is the predisposition of the interviewer himself or herself. How? Let us see that. Predisposition of the interviewer is also one area because of which the response may get affected. How does it get affected? If the researcher is feeling uncomfortable with the people whom he or she is going to interview, the response will definitely get affected. Maybe that person is too high level person, or this person is getting intimidated by the greatness of that person. These things, so that is why the interviewer is feeling uncomfortable. So these things affect the way we collect data and the way we get the data from the respondent. Another aspect is the interviewer may not be very comfortable with the environment in which these interviews are conducted. Suppose these interviews are to be conducted for the children in a jail. The interviewer is not so comfortable, never entered the jail. So that environment itself is not really conducive for this particular interviewer, and that may affect the kind of data which is collected by this interviewer. Sometimes it happens that if the interviewer allows his or her opinion to influence the response of the respondent. We have said earlier that we should not be showing very pleasure or shock or surprise even by words or by facial expression, we should not, we should be neutral. But this may happen and that will get the response affected, because the respondent immediately gets the cue and knows that whether this response was accepted or not accepted, and may change it accordingly. And this may get your data affected. Sometimes it happens the personality of an interviewer, of an interviewer, is such that he or she is not able to create a rapport between with that respondent. Sometimes this happens. And then there is a stiffness, there is a wall unnecessarily created, and that hampers the whole data collection process through this interview. How this is to be removed? The interviewer must be trained properly how to create rapport. Even if you don't like that person, even if you don't like the opinion of that person, you have to be neutral, because you are not here to share your opinions. You are here to get the opinions of the respondent. So that neutrality has to be maintained, and we must not, as an interviewer, must not get affected by this. Sometimes the opinion of the interviewer has certain kind of stereotypes. Say for example about gender, women are like this, men are like this. So he or she expects that kind of response from the respondent. If this is in contradiction, then this interviewer is not comfortable. He or she may have the stereotypes, how they should behave, what they should wear, how they should sit, how they should speak. These kind of stereotypes of the respondent, which are in the mind of interviewer, they come in a way of conducting this interview, getting this data, noting it. Because all the time, if something goes against the stereotypes, then the interviewer is not really ready to accept that. Stereotypes about somebody, how a teacher should behave, how a CEO should behave, how an illiterate woman behaves, these are the stereotypes many of us have. But they should not come in a way when we conduct the data through interview. There is the third aspect which should be understood, because it affects the response. And this is called the procedure we use for conducting the study. One of the important thing is how the study is explained to the respondent. What is this about? What are our objectives? Why we are conducting this study? And why your response is important? That must be made across to the respondent. In what way? How do we do that? If that is not done properly, if the respondent doesn't understand the importance of it, the relevance of it, the answer, the response is given may not be of very great high use for the researcher. The methods used for getting respondents' cooperation are also important. Are you going to give them the gift? Are you going to pay them something? That if you give me answers, I'll pay you 150 rupees. If that, what is it? How, why we have invited them, and what we are going to, how we are going to ascertain the cooperation. Many a times we never pay. We don't pay. But in certain interviews, researcher pays something, gives the gift, or there are some other ways in which the time is compensated. This procedure also may affect, because some people may not like this, giving gift, or some people may not like that you are not paying for their time. This may also affect. So before you select the sample, when you select the sample, it must be clarified, it must be clear on both sides, what is the procedure we are going to use for getting cooperation from the respondents. The length of the interview also is a very important aspect. Because if it is too long, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, in one sitting, is the respondent ready for that? Can we tell the respondent how much time is expected? So if that is known to them, they get ready. This, it will take 25 minutes or it will take 1 hour. When can I come? If you want to do the interview in two sittings, that also can be done. In one sitting at a stage, does this person have time? But if you conduct interviews for some respondents in two sittings and some respondent in one sitting, that also may have effect on the data, because you are changing the situation of conducting the interview. So you have to be careful in that. So you have to select sample who is ready to give you that time. One more aspect is where you are conducting the interview. Are you conducting the interview in a secluded place? Are you conducting interview in a whole class? Or you are conducting interview on a railway station or in a mall? So a lot of disturbances are there. There are people around you. You want to create some kind of confidentiality and it is not possible. Then both respondent and interviewer get agitated. So all these things matter where we conduct this interview. This is a procedural part and that may get your data affected. We have seen that the interviews are generally, individual interviews are one-to-one. If the presence of other people there may affect asking of questions or also may affect the answering of questions. So you have to establish the rules right in the beginning, whether only two people will be there in the room or you are allowing other people also to come in, go out, because this kind of mobility also affects. It will affect the attention. It may affect the confidentiality. People may hear what you are saying. So that may affect your recording of data. All these things are possible when, where you are conducting the interview and the presence of other people, that matters. So these are some of the things which the interviewer, the researcher must take care about how the data, how the responses may get affected. We want the least affected data. It should not get affected by extraneous or external variables. The interviewer should collect data what we expect. And that's why some of these things must be removed or decreased to minimum possible rate. Now with the kind of technology available to you as a researcher, arranging personal one-to-one in that particular room interviews is not necessary all the time. We can use new techniques and you can add to this, but there are two techniques which I can share with you. One is telephone interview and other thing can be computer assisted interview. Telephone interview is also one-to-one and we ascertain that so much of time is kept aside for this. You ascertain that that person is there at the other end and you don't have to give them, but travel time and being there, that time is, we invest, that time is left alone. And what we do, we conduct interview on telephone, which gets recorded, so that you don't have to look at the recording part of it. The telephone interview can get recorded because that instrument records. But again, you have to tell the respondent whether your interview is getting recorded. If he or she doesn't allow, then you can record it on your notes, on your interview guide. Other technique which generally is used is computer assisted. The whole interview is computerized, all the questions, and these questions are asked in human voice. That person knows that you are sitting there, we are recording. So now this person, the interviewer, doesn't have to worry about the next question. If yes, then go to 11. Then it goes to 11. Doesn't have to search for it. If this, then this probing question. So these kind of questions are already recorded and set. So this reduces the time of recording the answers and you can fully concentrate on what the respondent is saying. So this is another way of using new technique. There could be many other technologies available now. You have to find that and use it to the possible use. You have to put to possible use because it will reduce the effect of the extraneous variables. It would also reduce the effect of the responses on the responses due to these extraneous factors. There are many techniques for data collection. We have listed them: interview, questionnaire, checklist, rating scale, test, inventories, many things. Now, every instrument, every tool has some kind of advantages over others and also some kind of shortcomings or disadvantages. What are the advantages of interview schedule? One biggest thing is interview, because it is one-to-one, you can conduct an interview of even illiterate person who doesn't, not able to read. This is not possible with questionnaire, because questionnaire, that respondent has to read and respond. So that person has to be literate. With children, you can use interview, if not questionnaire, because you are not sure whether students will understand and then they will put a tick mark at the right place. So generally, this is an advantage of interview, that it can be conducted with all types of respondents. Usually the interview, because it is face to face, it is one to one, and even if there is a team, you have respondents sitting in front of you, you can get it clarified. So the kind of data which you collect is very rich, is valuable. It is already tested, because if you have not understood, if the answer is vague or ambiguous, there and then you get it clarified, which doesn't happen in questionnaire, for example. Because questionnaire you receive by post, and then that time when you come to know, oh, this answer is ambiguous, this is not a correct answer, then you going back to that person and getting the answer is very difficult, it's challenging. In interview, what happens is there and then you get the things clarified. That's why the data which is collected is very rich and valuable. Because this person is talking to the respondent in face-to-face mode, the presence is there, you can observe that person also. So it's not only the cognitive aspect of the person which you are talking about, because you are interested to know about opinions and thoughts and ideas. This is a cognitive part. But you also see the affective or emotive part. What are the feelings? What are the sensitive areas? How they are responding? What are the facial expressions? What are the body languages used? What are the non-verbal cues are given? All these things can be observed, and they help in supporting the cognitive messages which you got from the interview. As compared to questionnaire, the response rate is also very high, because you have taken appointment, you have gone there. So if you decide to conduct 30 interviews, you are conducting 30 interviews. One or two interviews may be failure because of certain reasons which are beyond your control. But almost all interviews are conducted when whatever you decide. This doesn't happen with questionnaire, because you send the questionnaire to 1,000 people and maximum 35% to 40% questionnaires are received back. It's that kind of response rate. And when you open those, they might not have written all the questions. You are telling them all questions are to be answered. They may select not to answer questions. So incomplete questionnaires is also another thing, because you can't use incomplete questionnaire. So that is not with the interview. Interview, because it is conducted there and then, all these aspects are removed. So over questionnaire, this is more valuable tool. So as compared to questionnaire, these interviews give more valuable and rich data. Interview is conducted in face-to-face situation, and that's why flexibility is possible. If you see that the person is not comfortable right now, then we can give some time in between and continue again. This doesn't happen with questionnaire, because you are not with the respondent. Respondent is sitting somewhere else in whatever situation, whatever mindset. We never know that. Here what happens, that because that rapport is created with the interviewer, with the particular individuals, with the particular circumstances, we know that. And that's why getting that data is easier as compared to questionnaire. Let us see what are the shortcomings or disadvantages of interview schedule. You may be thinking that we must use interview as a tool all the time, but which is not possible all the time, because it is very time consuming. Conducting interviews of 1,000 people for a researcher is really a great challenge. You will require a fleet of interviewers in your team. It is time consuming, because what happens with other tools, you just send it to people and then you retrieve them. Though the retrieval rate is small, your time is not invested in collecting the data. Of course, you have to do the follow-up, talk to them on phone, coax them to send the questionnaire and get it back, increase the response rate, yes. But conducting interviews takes a lot of time, and that's why it is time investment and also travel expensive. It is cost-wise also it is expensive, because you have to go there personally, the traveling cost is there, and there are some other costs which may be involved, you have to take care of that also. So it is expensive and time consuming. So while selecting interviews, we are very cautious. Generally what we do, we give the questionnaire to say 1000 people, you get 300 to 400 questionnaire back. Then to corroborate what they have given is right or wrong, then we take 10%, we select 10% sample out of those who have sent you the questionnaire and then interview them. So then you are interviewing only 40 people. And those 40 are also selected using certain criteria in order to corroborate the response which you have received from the questionnaire. Then from 1000 you have come down to 40, and still the kind of data which you have is very valuable and rich. So generally the researchers won't go for voluminous data through interviews. It also needs well qualified and trained manpower. Your interviewers need to be trained. And if you fail in your training, if they don't understand the importance, the sequence, the language, the way they should conduct, the way they should start, the way should they conclude, if it is not understood properly, then the interviews may fail. So it is training intensive tool. Because if you are not able to conduct all the interviews, you will appoint people and their training is very important. If they fail, that means the kind of data which they will bring you, it's not correct or proper data, and then you will be having your findings based on that. Another thing is that sometimes it happens, if they are in the field, they also need supervision. You have told them to collect the data through interview. Suppose they don't interview people, then what? So there should be a supervisor who constantly supervises the interview process. Where interview is going on, how much time they are taking, what they are doing, this needs to be supervised. So it's not only that you should have interviewers, field investigators, you also should have assistant, research assistants who can supervise these field investigators. Their training is also very essential, what they are supposed to supervise. This happens in big projects where a lot of people need to be interviewed, lot of data, variety of variables are involved, and it's a big team. That time you need this kind of cascading approach. It also happens that while you are interviewing a person, you are not able to record all the responses. So even if you have interview guide, you are putting tick mark and then you are trying to put some notes. Now immediately after this you go to another respondent, you go to third respondent, in a day you interview 5 people. And when you go back at home and on your desk, you may not remember exactly what you have written there. You have just scribbled something. So this is distorted information. There may be error in remembering. So all these things come into picture for interview. This doesn't happen with the observation schedule. This doesn't happen with the rating scale. This doesn't happen with the questionnaire. But with interview, because it is time intensive, you are not able to write down everything. And you may not recollect. So this is one of the disadvantages of interview as a tool for data collection. We have seen that interviews are generally structured. But if you try to bring in flexibility by making it semi-structured or unstructured, this flexibility affects your standardization. Then there may be inconsistencies across the data. Some interviewers may not be so flexible. Some may be too flexible, some may be medium level flexible. Now how do you standardize these responses got from the respondents by using this flexibility? So that is also a challenge, and that brings in another disadvantage of interview as a schedule, as a tool. If you interview a person for 1 hour, 2 hours, the kind of volume, that volume of the data is too huge, and to write it down, to then later code it, because there many a times there are open-ended questions. And whatever that person says, if you have not recorded on your tape recorder, then you have to really write it by hand. And that huge data may not get incorporated in the tool while you are conducting that interview. And that becomes another disadvantage. We have seen how to construct interview guide, and we have also seen how to conduct interviews. You may like to see the videos prepared based on the interviews and decide how to conduct interviews and how not to conduct interviews.